This is the 2003 Canadian National Squash Championships here in Edmonton. I'm Tom Bedore with the coach of the national men's team, Gene Turk. We're getting set for a great battle between Jonathan Power, world number 3, and Graham Ryding, world number 24. There's no question, Power is the favorite. What's your prediction, Gene?
Well, I think Power is the favorite, but he is coming off an eye injury that he received at the World, so he hasn't had as much competition as he would like to have. And Graham, he's refined his skills over the fall, and I think we're looking for a tough battle.
Well, we're ready for it. Let's go find out how these two players made it into the final.
I've improved my fundamentals, my game, my stroke making, and I think I'm more consistent. I got away from my environment that I've been in for the last sort of 10 years. It just gave me a chance to really work on things myself and just sort of start trusting myself a bit more with my game. And I'm going to play professionally for another 2 to 4 years, but I'm trying to move back into the top 10, so you know, that's my focus, and hopefully it takes, hopefully I get there, and hopefully it takes, you know, a season or so. In the past, you know, he's been effective against me when I've made it easier for him by just bringing a lot of easy points and errors into the game. So if I can make him beat me and actually earn his points rather than giving them to him, then I think I could maybe get into a more effective position against him rather than years past. I've made it too easy for him.
Well, I was always in Toronto, so I mean, I had Graham, of course, to train with, which is good. But he moved away to Amsterdam, so then I was basically left on my own in Canada for like top 10 level squash. So I mean, there's a small nucleus of guys I could play good squash, and I could do drills with, and do my training with in Montreal. So I wanted to pick it up and move it there. Just for a lifestyle change, claim your spot on the court, and make sure you don't let him take your positions. And so it's basically a fight for good position on the court, and we both like the same positions on the court. So every time there's going to be a lot of bumping and pushing and talking and stuff. So that's all right. It's good sport. Yeah, the eye did take a little while to repair itself. It was a pretty serious injury, but you know, back in. Got my timing back again, and yeah, I'm going to keep playing as long as I enjoy it. I'm having a good time, and maybe not playing as many tournaments as I am before, not concentrating on my ranking or that sort of thing. I'm slowing down on tournaments, but I'm enjoying training and playing, you know, top-level squash around the world. I play my game. I like to impose my game on all the players and play my style of game, because I know if it's working, then that's going to be, you know, that's my greatest strength.
Now here we go, a capacity crowd here at the Royal Glenora for what should be an epic battle for squash supremacy in Canada. Jonathan Power and Graham Ryding, and the first rally is underway. Gene Turk with me. Obviously, Jonathan Power being number 3 in the world, you have to give him the edge in play, but what do you think? Are we going to see 5 games here today?
I think this is going to be a tough battle. Normally, the two guys have played a lot because they're both living in Toronto, but now Graham's in Toronto and Jonathan's moved to Montreal. So they haven't played each other a lot lately, and I think Graham is ready for the challenge today. So I don't know if it'll go 5, but I think Graham's got a good chance.
Jonathan Power, famous for his discussions with the referees, and it's already started here.
Well, Jonathan likes to keep them on their toes. You know, he knows the game. Nobody knows the game as well as he does, and he likes to keep them on their toes, make sure that they know where he thinks the game should go, and then it gives him an edge on some of the calls.
Good point. And not to mention the fact that he is one of the wittiest guys I think you'll ever run into. He comes up with some very creative lines from time to time.
Yeah, I think, you know, the nice thing about Jonathan, not only plays a good game of squash, but he entertains the crowd through his witty lines.
He is the full-fledged entertainer. He's got the whole package.
Full meal deal. Right?
Full meal deal. And he quickly jumps out to a 2-love lead in this game.
One of the things that you'll see Jonathan do is at the start of this match, he's going to try and take the pace up high so that he's going to try and make Graham feel uncomfortable with the extreme high pace at which he can fight comfortably.
And Jonathan being number three in the world, former number one, and some people would say still the very best, the best player in the world. There's a big difference between number 24 and being in the top five in the world, no question. So there's a different level there, isn't it?
Yeah, I think, you know, they can play pretty much the same game, but I mean, Jonathan is amazing with his racket skills. But the other thing is that he can play the game at a pace at which most players.
Yeah, not happy with that call. Stroke against him. I guess he thought he got out of the way. And I've noticed at the higher levels, these players, they hit some fat shots, some shots that are away from the sidewall, but they're so fast in getting out of the way that very often the call doesn't go against them.
Well, you know, I guess if you get out of the way and let the guy play it, then you shouldn't. There's no interference.
Some of the shots in this rally would have been long over for most players in this room. Another one. Look at most of these shots that Jonathan's hitting. They're going into the neck, but Graham, with his great retrieving ability, is able to get them. But not that one. Now, the scoring, unlike with the women, it's a point per rally. So every time there's a serve, there will be a point awarded, unless it's a let and they have to replay it. The game goes to 15. How has that changed the game?
Well, what I like about it is that what used to do sometimes, school of thumb was in the nine-point scoring, is that you could only score on your serve. So if you were serving, you might be a little more aggressive and take a few more chances. But if you weren't serving, you would play defensive. Whereas when it's a point per rally, every rally is played the same. So it has its benefits to catching up quickly or taking off. But it also has its negatives that you can't afford to make too many errors and let a guy run five quick points. But I think for the fans, you know, every point is rewarded. And for the players, every point is the same.
Well, the game certainly seems to be a lot more offensive these days, and I suppose that's a part of it. Crowned Canadian champion in the plus 40 men's category earlier today. Congratulations.
Hey, thanks, Tom.
You had a pretty... You weren't pressed too much, but from what I've heard, at least, no question, you are the top plus 40 guy in the country. What was your toughest match in the course of the week?
I played well in the final today, so that's the only one I seem to remember.
How many Canadian champions is that for you now?
I think that makes 10.
Are you serious? 10
yeah.
Canadian championships. Congratulations.
You know what? It took till I was a master to win one.
You're watching the 2003 Canadian National Squash Championships at the Royal Glenora Club on TSN. You're watching the 2003 Canadian National Squash Championships at the Royal Glenora Club on TSN. Two walls meet. It's called the squelch, and it pops right out in the middle. Just prior to this match getting underway, Jonathan Power out in the middle of the crowd. Interesting player. He loves to mingle with the crowd. Most players, prior to the match, they'll be stretching, they'll be doing some visual exercises, psyching themselves for the match. Power looks like he's a kid arriving at the playground to play his favorite game, and I guess that's exactly what he is doing.
You know, each player has to find what it takes for them to relax and perform at the level at which they want to perform. And, you know, Jonathan, he's a world champion. He's starting to figure it out, and it's just different from other people's routines. You know, other people get serious. He likes to take the seriousness out. He doesn't want to be nervous, and so he prefers to socialize and walk in a happy feeling.
One of the interesting things I think about Jonathan Power, too, and interviewed him earlier today, many players at a certain juncture of the game, if they get up sometimes, oh, a great, great winning shot there for Jonathan Power, who's now moved into an 11-2 lead. And as I mentioned before, this is now a commanding lead. he can close this one out and win the first game here by just keeping Graham in the back of the court. But many players, when they're down, or sometimes when they get a big lead, they'll go into a bit of a conservative shell and not try anything. Jonathan Powers never does that. He always seems more than willing, it doesn't matter what the score is, to go in the attack.
Yeah, he's got a certain style about him. This is why he likes to play in rallies. There's no point in changing my style. This is what got me here, so I'm going to keep going. And then if he makes some errors, then he'll calm down. But there's no point in stop doing something when it's working. You know, I don't think Graham has settled in yet. You know, Forte is going to be down a game before he does settle in. But he's got to start. You watch his shots right now, and they're about half a foot off the wall. You watch his shot last night against Razic Shahir, and everything was tight onto the wall. So he just hasn't got it yet. He's got to try and find it before the second game comes on.
It's got to be tough for Graham. I mean, Graham is a former Canadian champion a number of times, but he never was able to beat Jonathan Power at these Canadian championships. They've been roommates. They know each other's game so well, and Jonathan always seems to come out on top. It's got to be tough.
Yeah, and some of them have been.
And a little showmanship there from Jonathan. With the referee once again.
He didn't like the call, but he was still in the way, and it was a stroke call.
At Nationals a couple of years ago in Calgary, I guess it'd be several years ago now, it was Jonathan and Graham in the final. I remember that was one that was close. It went five, and all the kids in the crowd, of course, were cheering for Jonathan. At least that's what it seemed like. And I remember it looked like Graham was going to beat him. And these kids were almost in tears, it seemed like. And, of course, Jonathan did pull it out at the end.
You know, that I can remember that match. And Graham should have won that. You know, Graham's had some bad luck. He played the better squash. He was the better player on that day. And I just remember there was a few calls, et cetera, that went his way that just changed the momentum. And from all the years that I've watched Jonathan, the one thing I have to say is he is a winner. He will find a way to win. And if there's ever the TSN turning point, he finds it and he changes the momentum and he comes out on top.
He's a master at it, and he's a master at using the crowd. And here he is at game point, 14-3, and they'll replay that as Graham gets a let on that rally. And that's tougher for Graham, and he goes down 15-3 in the first game.
We'll be back with more squash action at the 2003 Canadian National Squash Championships on TSN.
Okay, here we go. It's game two. Jonathan Power wins the first one, 15-3, and despite that score, Graham was playing well, but Jonathan took it. By the score, it looks relatively easy. Graham is playing awesome. I mean, that victory yesterday against Razic, who beat him earlier this year in a big tournament in the States. I thought that one could have been close, but he won that one in four. Graham's playing great squash. He just doesn't seem to be getting any results so far here today.
Yeah, I think this fall he's worked quite hard on his game. I've had a lot of conversation with him, and he's happy with the training that he's done. He's happy with the way he's playing. Now he just needs some results. And I think he came into this match ready to show everybody how much better he's improved and how he is playing. And that first game was just going to make him mad. So I'm hoping that now he can settle down, play the squash that he wants to show everyone he can play, and we're going to see a great match.
That's right. Well, he certainly seems to be doing it in this particular rally, and he gets a stroke. Yeah, it already looks a lot better. And he takes the first lead of the match so far at 2-1.
Well, that's a great get. Great get and great touch.
Unbelievable. That was a great drop shot by Graham, and Jonathan just goes up and hits a better pad. He thought he hit a winner and that Graham couldn't get to it, and it was close.
He did hit a winner. He hit a great shot there. But Graham played on that. Sometimes Jonathan will hit a winner and supply a little block. And, you know, the ref felt that he had obstructed Graham to not get that ball, so he opted to give him a let, even though Jonathan's right. He wouldn't have gotten to it if he had had a clear pass.
bonuses coming to watch Jonathan Power play squash is his witty comments between points. And he hits that one into the tin, and Graham is on a roll here.
I think we're going to see a bit of the niceties be gone for a while, and Jonathan's going to bear down right now. He knows it's 12-10. He wants to win this game. He doesn't want to lose this game.
He doesn't want to go three. He doesn't want to go five games.
He'd rather have it 3-0.
Absolutely.
So I think we'll see him bear down from here to the end of this game.
Tough one for Graham. It popped out, and it's a stroke, and that makes it 13-10 after a great comeback by Graham, where he was down 12-7.
Graham was playing the better squash there in the middle of that game. Oh, no.
Now that's a tough call. Oh, that's too bad. That's important. That's really important. So here we go with game three. Power up, two games to love. Graham losing that second game in a very difficult fashion after making a great comeback at 12-7 and then getting a tough stroke call at 13-10. And then a conduct stroke to end the match. Or end the game, rather.
Well, he looked surprisingly settled again, so I hope that for that 90 seconds he was able to get rid of all the anger. And he looks like he's done that.
Let's call on that. Power leading, one love.
Most people don't get a chance to see this type of court setup that they play with all over the world in their major events. And it's so good for a squash. And it's really nice to have these guys being able to play the same squash that they play in the British Open or etc. in the bigger events, now being able to play it at their Canadian Championship.
Absolutely. And looks like we're getting another professional. Power very unhappy with that last call, and Graham has tied it up at one apiece. And another interesting comment from Jonathan Power. I was about to say another professional tournament for Canada here in Edmonton is planned for October, and they'll have the glass court at the West Edmonton Mall, which will be a great showcase for squash.
That will be a great showcase for squash, and it'll be great for Edmonton to see all the other top players around the world and how Jonathan plays against these other guys, the other top performers. And Graham will be here, and Shahir Razik, all the Canadian team.
Back in the game, it's 9-13. Jonathan Power needs two more points to win the Canadian Championship. That should have been a winner and would have been against any other player, that brilliant boast by Graham Ryding. And there's another great drop shot. And again, Graham asks for a let and gets it, and they replay the rally.
They had to play the let. Definitely in the way, but when he turned around and saw what great length he had hit, he wanted him to call no less.
Oh, there's some what pecan. A flurry of activity there, and somehow the rally is still on. Oh. And then back to shots up the rail. there's so much deception that you don't even feel up here that Graham is feeling right now, and he makes it look easy. Oh, and Graham hoping for a stroke there, and the crowd thought it should have been. And they'll replay it again at 9:13. Sometimes the game just doesn't seem to be fair.
I think Jonathan threw him a little smile after that.
Oh, and again, an unforced error from Jonathan Power, who doesn't seem to be in too big a hurry to win this, although that probably would have been a winner if it had been 2 inches higher. That's unfortunate for Graham Riding. He should have asked for a let there. Obvious, a lot of contact, interference, and would have most certainly got the let and perhaps a stroke.
Now I think he felt that he wasn't going to get a stroke, so he'd be better off playing it. Oh, and it hit the nick on the third.
Well,
the other national champion, Jonathan Donovan.
Number 3 in the world, and still number 1 in Canada, Jonathan Pollard.
Well, last time we had a really tough game. We played in New York, and I think I barely won that one in 4 and a couple of close games. I could easily lost that one, so I knew it was going to be tough, and I had to bear down and play pretty well and controlled it from the beginning, so I was happy with that. Yeah, I was a little bit worried about how my sharpness was going to be, and it's good to get these matches, you know, under my belt. You know, I wasn't too sure what kind of squash was going to turn up on the court today, but I was happy with the way I played, and my game's back to where it was.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Well, there we have it. Jonathan Power once again, the 2003 Canadian National Squash Champion. A great battle with Graham Riding. A tough fight for Graham. He played well, probably well enough to win against any other opponent. But unfortunately, it was Jonathan Power, number 3 in the world. Great battle for Graham Riding, though.
It was a great battle. It was a great match to watch. Jonathan's a true champion. He kept Graham off edge all the time, would let him get settled. Graham needed to get settled if he was going to have a chance. But that's what true champions do. They keep him off guard.
Thanks, Gene, and thanks for watching the 2003 Canadian National Squash Championships.